Hi, I'm Dr. Will Kuhn, Director of Science and Research for Discover Life in America, and I'm going to talk to you today about dragonflies and damselflies. Dragonflies and damselflies belong to a group of insects called the Odonata, and they're two kind of subgroups of that. And they all are very good flyers as adults, but they also spend most of their life in the water. Their nymph, the juvenile stage of a dragonfly or damselfly, actually lives in the water and is a voracious predator. And then they go through a few different molts and then eventually hatch out as an adult. And the adult stage flies around, has wings. And they're these just really incredible, very agile, really interesting creatures that have really cool behaviors and are just fun to watch and to study. Dragonflies and damselflies can be found in the water for most of their life, in the nymphal stage. You can use a net to kind of sift through the water around banks, roots, standing water, or moving water. And then the adult stage can be found close to water, where they're mating and laying eggs, but also sometimes you find them flying over fields, areas considerably away from water, and there's some species that migrate as well. Dragonflies throughout their whole life are predators, voracious predators. My advisor used to call them the lions of the insect world. And when they're juvenile, the juvenile stage in the water, they eat all kinds of small invertebrates, worms and other insects, and can even eat things as big as small fish, like minnows, and even tadpoles. So this insect can actually eat vertebrates, things like frogs and fish. And then as adults, they feed on anything that is winged. They will grab bees and butterflies and flies and mosquitoes. They especially like mosquitoes, which is beneficial to humans. They will feed on all kinds of winged insects, whatever they can get a hold of, and occasionally even things like hummingbirds, although that's really rare. So they have kind of two distinct life stages. When they're in the water, they're fed on by fish and other insects and other invertebrates. And as adults, they can be eaten by frogs and spiders, birds, all kinds of things, whatever can catch them. Dragonflies are special and important as the nymphs in the water. You can actually, as you're looking for stuff in the water, scientists can use those to tell how clean the water is. So if you find certain species in the water, you know that it's a cleaner environment. And if you find other species or no species at all, then you know that it's in not as good of shape. They are also part of the aquatic and terrestrial ecosystem. So they're predators both in the water and on land. And they eat things like mosquitoes and black flies and other insects that bother people. So they're beneficial in that way. And they're also just incredibly fascinating. Scientists learn a lot by studying dragonflies, by studying these really amazing suites of behaviors that they have, by studying their wing movements and how aerodynamic and how agile they are. We can learn things like better ways to make autonomous drones. People can help dragonflies by first just being aware that they exist, but also by keeping habitat in good shape. Things, especially ponds and river systems, lakes, things like that, keeping the habitat quality good, keeping nice native vegetation around the edges of things like ponds instead of just mowing it flat really helps out dragonflies. And you can even install a pond in your yard, and that will attract dragonflies and a bunch of other neat insects as well, as and birds.